I have a shared folder on my C drive, where all of my PI ProcessBook displays are kept. These files end in PDI and have a red and gray icon. And while I can keep coming back to this folder every time I need to look at a different display, this can be disorganized, require flipping through different windows, and memorizing file names. In fact, I was working on a display yesterday, and I can't quite remember what the file name was. But that's okay because I can use PI ProcessBook to help jog my memory. Every time you open up PI ProcessBook, you're greeted by the home page. The default home page is this PI ProcessBook, and PI ProcessBooks will have different tabs, as well as a hierarchy with links to other locations. For instance, if I click this run mode and double click on paper machine, I'm brought to this paper machine display, and after inspecting the various symbols on it, I can close it to return to my book and then click on a different display that I might be interested in. This is a great way to organize your displays and other links, but it has nothing to do with the display I was looking for, so I'm going to close it to find that display. Now, the first place I'll look is in my History tab. So opening my bookmark organizer, I would see any bookmarks if I had any right here, but I'm interested in the History tab. Unfortunately, the History tab will only record places you've been to in the current PI ProcessBook session. To look back earlier than that, we can open up the address bar and see more places that we've been through. So let's guess that this is the display I was working with yesterday. So no, this isn't quite it, but I know it's linked to this display through this boiler button. Aha, this is the display I was looking for. Alright, so I'm going to add it to my bookmarks so that I don't lose track of it again. So clicking on this star here will add it to the bookmark toolbar. Now, every time I go to a different display, I can always return to my boiler overview by using the bookmark. So let's go back to that area overview display. And we can see that this is a pretty useful display. It has a lot of information dealing with critical process data that has to do with my plant, as well as links to lots of the other places in my plant if I want to get a better view. For example, here in my generator, I can see the nitty-gritty details of my generator. Because this is such a great reference page, what I'm going to do is make this my new homepage. I'll click this down arrow and use current. So now, every time I open up PI ProcessBook, I'll immediately be met with my area graphic overview, where I can see my critical data, as well as link to anything I might want to see more information of. So this is an okay setup for me, but now that I've gone through all of that, I want to set up a system so that other users can find what they're looking for too, and I'll accomplish this by creating a book file for me as well as other plant operators to use. So first I'll close everything I'm working on right now, and make a file, new, process book PIW file. So let's call it plant overview. And I'll save this in the location with all my other displays. And we'll call it plant overview. Alright, so this is a display file like we saw at the beginning of the video with a binding, and eventually it'll have tabs too. So to start making entries, we'll make a new ProcessBook entry. And the first one will be a text entry, because we need a title. So we'll call the first title Displays, and note that it's on level 1. That means it's going to make a tab. So we'll hit OK, and we can see here we've got a title with a display tab. So let's start adding some displays as entries. File, New, Entry. We'll first add a new display. So I'm going to call this first display Critical Plant Data. And I'm going to make it level 2 so that it tucks underneath anything that's level 1. So hitting OK, we can see that my critical plant data display is now tucked underneath my display page. We also open up the display so that we can start working on it right away. Now, I'm not going to build out this display right now, but I will do is create a button to link back to my book file so that users can just simply click on it to return. So here in my button, I'll drag and drop one, and I'll call this return to book, where the action is where I want it to go. So what I'll do is simply browse to that location, and here it is, and we'll hit OK. So now that switching to run mode will open up my display and then use my return to book icon to return to my book file. So that's how you create an embedded display. But what about a display that you already have and you just want to link to it? We'll make a new entry. And this time we'll link to a display. So here, like the button we just made, we'll put in the action of the location we want to go to. So I'll add the Wintopia revenue display, and we'll call it Wintopia revenue. And we'll keep it on level 2, so it's underneath my display page. So hitting OK, it opens up the Wintopia display by default, and closing it, we go back to our book file, where we have our display title, and then the two links underneath. Now, I know that some other plan operators refer to Excel files and certain web pages quite often, so what I can do for them is create a new tab with links on it to some of those other useful places and files. So I'll make a new entry, and this one will be another text entry, and we'll call these other links. We're going to bump it up to level 1, so it's on the same level as the tabs, and hit OK. So the first thing you'll notice is that it took over my Wintopia revenue and my critical plant data. So to see why that happened, we can switch to build mode and view the outline view. So when we do that, we see that my other links entry was sandwiched between my displays and my two links. So what we can do is select the two links and move them around with these arrow keys. We can promote them, demote them, and move them up and down. So let's move them up underneath the display entry. So now they're tucked underneath displays again. Since this is a pretty good way to visualize our books, let's stay in this while we make our two last links. So again, file new, we'll make an entry, and this time I'll make a link to one of their Excel files they use pretty often. So I'll browse to it, and I know it's up a level from my displays folder, and I'll filter by all files, and there's the plant data source configuration file. So what I'll do is I'll select it, and then I'll label it plant data source configuration. All right, so we'll hit OK. And it automatically opens, but I'll just close it again. And here what I'll do is I'll slide it down underneath other links. So we'll down, 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 and then I'll demote it to tuck it underneath. There we go. All right, and we'll make the last link. And I'll make another link. And this time I'll link to the OSIsoft tech support website. And I can just type in the URL. And while you're typing in the action field, you can't hit OK. So what I'll do is select the label again and then hit OK. And then the page will open by default, so we can just close it. And now we can see our two links tucked underneath displays and our other links tucked underneath other links. So viewing the book mode again, here's our displays tab with my two displays and my other links with my two useful other links. So far in this video, we learned how to navigate ProcessBook displays using favorites, history, and buttons, as well as PI ProcessBook book files. And as I've developed my PI ProcessBook book file, I'll continue to add more embedded displays and linking other important displays that I'll need easy access to.